All right, so that wasn't so bad. You're able to compute some probabilities from this joint distribution. So let's see what happens when we start talking about more variables, more propositions that could be true or false. What I did is I filled in thunder as another variable, and thunder can be true or false in each of these cases, and I wrote down what the probabilities could be from my experience in Atlanta in the summer. I was around over last summer and in 2004. So I'm an expert, obviously. So I'm able to estimate these probabilities to the nearest percent. Anyway, the point is that one of the things you should notice here is that each time we add one variable, what happens to the number of probabilities that we have to write down?
Well, in a world where it's binary, it goes up by two.
A factor of two, right? Not just two more, but like twice as many. And so if we have a complicated scenario that we want to be able to reason about, and it's got, I don't know, 100 variables, that's going
to
be a lot.
I can't even
it's like 2 to the 100 is
that's not even a real number.
It's technically a real number, but it's an unimaginably large number.
There's only like four numbers: 1, 2, 3, many, and too many.
So it's going to be really inconvenient as we start adding more of these, and especially if we add variables like, you know, remember the restaurant example that we worked on? We were doing decision trees.
Oh yeah, those were the days.
Then there was variables like food type, and what was the deal with food type?
It had lots of values that it could take on.
Yeah, like 5 or something like that.
Thai and American and Italian and.
Right, and so if we add a variable like that, it's going to multiply the number of probabilities that we need by 5. So this is going to get really big, really fast. So wouldn't it be nice if we had a more convenient way of writing down this distribution?
Yeah, it would be nice.
So it turns out that we can factor it.
But I thought we already had a factor of 2.
Well, that was a joke, but it actually is pretty close to being the truth, which is the idea that instead of representing all, so in this case, there's 8 numbers. Instead of representing them as 8 numbers, we're going to represent it by, 2 times 2 times 2. So we really are going to essentially factor it, putting things into pieces that we can recombine, smaller pieces that we can recombine into larger pieces. And it turns out that actually works out really well.